Sergio, can you come there? Who's around there?
This came for you.
Really? What is it?
Not sure.
Great, new cereal.
Oh, did you get my pumpkins?
Yeah, just eating them now. Pretty good, actually.
Yeah, they're called secret pieces. They're good, ain't they?
Remarkable. What are they made from?
That's my own shit.
Well, Peter.
No, I mean, that's my multicoloured rabbit droppings. Like, I go into a chamber and I eat like loads of vitamins and pieces of rainbow. I make rainbow kebabs and they spin round and I slice bits of rainbow, I put it in pita bread and then I munch it down till like, I'm big and fat and ready. And then I just pump them out through my blue shorts straight into the packets. I can do like 7 packets a week.
I see. I'm very Moorish.
That'll be the nicotine. When I first made them, they looked like hundreds and thousands, but more swollen. So I called them 10s and 20s, and I was going to use them as cake decoration. So like, I phoned up Mr. Kipperban, you know, the cake doctor, and he said, go fuck yourself. But, you know, I think they go better with milk anyway.
So are they in the shops then?
No, but they're outside the shops, by the bush.
Yeah, all right, see that, Peter.
Yeah, nice one. Don't call me again, yeah?
Gentlemen, we are primed and ready to go.
You have 3 minutes until takeoff and 2.5 minutes to prepare your main course. I will see you in the holding pattern. Good luck and God bless America. Clickety click. Now, will you, Rodriguez? Oh, boy! I think I'm one of them lizard people. Harold Faltermeyer, disguised as an octopus, blowing a whistle, reminding you you're fresh out of goddamn paprika. Rodriguez, put a shot of bourbon in that, will you? To board your vessel.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Perfect job, Patriots.
No
high class. I do not cyclone like Miss Kite. And I haven't got a snazzy car like Mr. Ebsen. And I will not get on the bus for you, horrible little lot. I ride the pommel horse home like every PE teacher should. That's a little joke for the tiny one. You see, I can be a character like Mr. Clansby. I just need a chance to shine.
Peter.
Hey, no, who's the best film star who ever lived?
Kurt Russell.
Yeah, what's the best film that's ever been made?
Big Trouble in Little China.
I told you, Nathan, you idiot. I gotta go, no, I'm in the pub.
Yeah, great.
I'm Sergeant Raymond Boombox. As you may or may not know, in 1975, I received a knife wound in the line of duty. A knife wound that started talking to me. And occasionally helped me solve cases.
Helped you on some of your cases? I solved most of them, you fat son of a bitch!
Shut up, you freak. I'm trying to put you in some kind of goddamn context. Anyway, one of the most exciting cases we worked on was when we were in Miami undercover. Hooper, what was the name of that case?
What do you mean, the one where you're wearing the pink denim shorts? You look ridiculous, you big fat pumpkin ass sticking out.
You picked those out for me! What were you wearing anyway, your wife's skirt?
It was a sarong, actually, and it was your wife.
You do not have access to my wife's sarong collection. You mind your mouth.
Ah, of course he did. He was banging her. Everyone knows that.
He was not banging her. They just happened to be at the same night school doing the same dance classes.
Yeah, we were doing modern tap and urban hip-hop.
Precisely. Thank you, Hooper. You be quiet. Anyway, we were down in Miami and I looked like one piece of hot ass. We'd offloaded some drugs to a known local dealer called Figo the Fruit Fly. Name so because everything he landed on turned rotten. All we had to do was get a payment off this guy and we could bust his thorax. Working with these scumbags was absolutely terrifying. If they even sniffed you out as a cop, not only would they kill you, but they could make things very awkward for you. It didn't bother me. I was a frightening mimic. An unbelievable actor, like a slightly hairier Kirk Douglas without the deformed chin. I could slap in with these guys as soon as look at them. Speak the lingo. I was one of them.
Yo, I gave you the money. What say you give me the drugs and go out and get a couple of chicks and a couple of beers?
What?
That's no better. Try it slower or faster. Christ, that's not helping anything. Put your eyes away. What are you saying to me?
Hey, Steve, do you take a card?
Do I take cards? Of course I don't take cards. What do I look like, a cash machine?
I do. So, put your card in my mouth and I'll be happy to handle your transaction.
What the hell are you doing?
Shut up! Would you like a receipt for that, sir?
Yes, please. The goddamn gash ate Figo's card. Needless to say, he was not a happy bunny. He produced the Norman sword and slashed me across the belly pouch with the speed and agility of a NASA cyborg. Oh! Oh, my God! What's wrong with you? What are you, a reenactment? Because of the gash, the whole drug bust went tits up, and things went from bad to worse.
Oh my God, somebody call an ambulance. This guy's in trouble.
Oh, really? What do you know? You a doctor?
No, I am not a doctor, thank you very much, but my brother-in-law happens to be one, so we've been around a lot of accidents, okay?
Oh, as if you're married. You just appeared there on a fat guy's gut.
Could you try not to insult me while you're insulting someone else? If you hadn't eaten the card in the first place, we wouldn't be in this mess.
But it was so good. It was light flavor.
Oh, my God. It was so not light flavor. It was Barclays.
It's Barclays, not Barclays, you goddamn schmuck.
Oh, Barclays, Barclays, bite me.
Oh, for God's sake, somebody call me an ambulance. Use your phone.
I can't. I got no battery.
Well, use your phone, then.
I can't help you. I got no cell phone.
Fine, I'll call the old goddamn ambulance. Near the ambulance. We're gonna be fine. Oh, great, very funny.
Sorry, Sarge. I got a gift for mimicking different types of emergency sirens.
Well, good luck on new faces. I'll bleed to death here if you haven't noticed.
Okay, does anyone want to hear my impersonation of Michael Caine?
No, we do not want to hear your impersonation of Michael Caine. Shut up.
You're a big man, but you're out of shape.
And so Figo got away with the drugs. I had to crawl on my goddamn hands and knees to the hospital. But they fixed me up good, and we decided to stay on in Miami for a week's holiday. Me and the gash got loaded on cocktails, and poor Hooper was mistaken in his sarong for a lady of the night. Oh, how we laughed when he was almost gangbanged by 15 sailors. I laughed so hard, I burst open my tummy stitches, and my tummy gashed. Regaled the whole party with his impersonations of Michael Caine and Harry Dean Stanton. A fabulous holiday and one I'll always remember. Join me next week. And remember, always keep a knife under your bed because most people are murdered by the person they love the most. And I look at a lot of corpses, and most of those corpses have been violated and raped before they've been murdered. So, at least a screwdriver. I mean, it's your choice.
Bye, bye, everyone.
Good night.